I was born in Rwanda, in a big family, of course, and I did my studies there, and then I got a job. I was working as an accountant for some years. Then, 1994, after 6 years of working there, the war happened. The genocide of Rwanda happened, so I had to run. And we went to England. We applied for asylum there. We got it. Arrived in England. I was lucky again. I got a job with a multinational train company that gave me the opportunity to travel to Europe, where I visited many other survivors of the Rwandan genocide. Then I realized they were being traumatized by the events of the genocide. They were like sheep without a shepherd. They were just lost, especially women. I feel I'm a voice for refugees, not only a voice, but I see a lot of potentialities in them. I did not think my child, who was dying in my hands when I was running away, and I did not have hope for her at that time, but I never thought she could make it, she could study, make it up to university in Oxford. Now she's doing her master's, and I feel this is something I could encourage other refugees to do, and I've been doing that, and I see a lot of healing and restorations in those ways. When I read what it was, peace building among people displaced by violence and the war, I felt this was mine. Because there's still a war among even those people displaced by war. And for instance, among Hutus and the Tutsis of Rwanda, even though they are in exile, you can tell there's still conflicts among them. And I have been privileged to have access to both tribes, and they trust me, and they thought maybe I should come and find a way I could help them. If you don't have peace, you can't give it to anyone. You cannot draw water from an empty well. So therefore, you have to have peace by yourself. And the way to have it is to recognize that you miss it, and then find a way to get it. This is a skill I feel would help many, many traumatized refugees or migrants to overcome their situation and move on.